Arthur.
And I'm Vivian.
And we're your hosts for What's New at Microsoft 365. And today we're going to talk about what's new in July. Last month, we came on the show and introduced ourselves as content creators. But we wanted to take a step back for a second and actually share what we do.
We're writers here at Microsoft. And we're part of teams that create the support content that you might find on support.office.com and support.microsoft.com. So while we have working knowledge of the features that we're covering in these monthly updates, we're by no means the subject matter experts or authorities on the topic. But we're here to learn more and to help you learn more by getting you the information you need. And in some cases, we'll even take you to the experts so they can share updates with you directly.
Before we get started on this month's updates, we wanted to address last month's video. We asked for your thoughts about the show, and you guys delivered. We've read all of your comments and appreciate you taking the time to share them. First off, thanks so much to everyone for continuing to watch the series as it evolves. We're still experimenting with the right formula for this show, and a lot of what you see will come from the direct feedback you share with us.
We understand the reputation that the series has, and we hope to evolve this show as thoughtfully and responsibly as we can. And as we continue to experiment with this format in the coming months, we really hope you guys will stay with us for the ride.
We'd also like to thank people who shared constructive feedback on how to improve. We received several comments for the full agenda, so we're bringing it back this month. You'll find it on the left side of the screen to keep you on track with all the new and exciting features we'll be covering. Speaking of new features, let's get started with this month's updates. We're starting off with new updates to help you discover and protect against cybersecurity threats. Thanks to FIDO Technologies, if you're an admin, you'll be happy to hear that you can now provide users with secure, passwordless access to apps and services to Azure AD. With this feature, you can assign passwordless credentials to users and groups, and even allow self-service signups. Check out these steps to enable passwordless sign-in for Azure AD.
I believe this was announced back in the spring, but Microsoft Threat and Vulnerability Management, or TVM, is now available to the general public. Let's chat briefly with an expert to find out more about this update. I'm here with Heike Ritter. She is a senior product manager for the M365 Securities Group, and she's here to talk to us today about TVM.
Thanks for having me.
Thanks for joining us on set. First of all, what is TVM and what does it do for our customers?
So TVM stands for Threat and Vulnerability Management, and it helps customers to discover, prioritize, and remediate threat and vulnerabilities on their endpoints. Threat and Vulnerability Management is a new capability of Microsoft Defender ATP, which is our endpoint security solution.
And if I don't have Microsoft Defender ATP, how can I try this out?
So customers can actually sign up for a trial. They just go to this link and then sign up and start discovering threats and vulnerabilities and misconfigurations on their endpoints.
Awesome. Well, thanks so much for joining us today.
Thank you.
Moving on to productivity and collaboration. If you're using Outlook on the desktop, you can now add polls to your Outlook emails with Microsoft Quick Polls. When you send out a poll via email, recipients can vote directly from there or click a link in their email to vote in their browser. Then you can check poll results directly from the voting card in your email. To start creating polls, all you need to do is download the Quick Polls add-in for Outlook.
There's something new for Outlook on the web too. Now you can easily book meeting rooms. In a meeting invite, you'll be able to see which rooms are available and search by city or room. You can even view which rooms are available during a recurring event. Yammer is also getting a new update this month. The Yammer team introduced a new feature to help questions stand out from the general discussion. As a post author or a group admin, you can now mark the best response to questions as a best answer, making it stand out to users looking for answers. This update will roll out to all users this summer.
If you want to collaborate more in Microsoft To Do, you'll be happy to hear that you can now assign a task to someone on a shared to-do list. Just @mention someone to assign them to a task, and everyone on this shared list will be able to see it. The Excel team also added new charts to help better visualize rich data. To try it out, select Insert, Charts to explore the new options.
For those working in IT management, the public preview for Desktop Analytics is now available. Desktop Analytics is an intelligent cloud service that helps you make decisions about the readiness of your Windows clients ahead of upcoming Windows 10 deployments. Basically, it's designed to create an inventory of the Windows apps running in your organization. You can then assess app capability with the latest feature update of Windows 10. To try it out, go to your Config Manager console and enable the service from there.
Also available for IT admins, there's a new and improved Office app experience in virtual environments. FX Logic's technology is now available, which will improve the performance of Office 365 ProPlus in multi-user virtual environments. This is now available at no additional cost for Microsoft 365 customers. Also, Windows Server 2019 will support Office 365 ProPlus and OneDrive files on demand in the coming months. And lastly, Outlook, OneDrive, and Microsoft Teams are getting new capabilities that'll improve the experience in a virtual environment.
Now we have a series of quick updates to end with. Are you ready?
Yes.
A new, faster, modern experience for Outlook on the web has arrived. Sign in and check out Outlook's latest paint job.
The OneDrive Personal Vault is now here, which is a protected area in OneDrive that only you can access via a strong authentication method or second step of identity verification.
Microsoft Teams has several updates this month. Now, Teams will help users prioritize time-sensitive communication, manage interactions more across teams and schedules, and simplify IT management of teams. For small business owners, we have 6 Outlook mobile tips and tricks to help you save time and get more done quickly, like using powerful search in your inbox or managing your email.
And in South Africa, Office 365 services are now available from the South African Data Center from cloud regions based in Cape Town and Johannesburg.
Okay, that's all we've got for July updates. Thanks again, everyone, for hanging with us this month. Like we mentioned earlier, we're still tweaking the series format. So just like last time, leave us your thoughts and comments down below. And we'll see you next month.
Bye.